from Hawaii. This is Martina Wing again with the manta rays. I talk about manta rays every week at 11 o'clock on Wednesdays. And today I want to talk about the comparison, a simple comparison between pelagic and reef mantas. But I thought I'd bring you a little bit of props of today. And, you know, one of the big things about reef mantas and pelagic manta rays is size difference. So just want to give you these little mantas as a prop so you can see what we're talking about. By the way, I'm doing this here in Kona, Hawaii for about 19 years. I'm very, very passionate about the animal. And I have a little knowledge. I have definitely a lot of footage because I'm diving with them for so long. And I'd just love to share my stuff that I accumulated over the years, not only my stuff, also my husband. And then Ryan worked for us so long. And so our team, we just have these huge archives. And I just really, really like to enjoy talking about and showing you the imagery we have over the years. So eventually I'm going to skip over to the other side with the camera. I flip it over and so you have a screen and then we can show you some props. But I do want to show you one more thing, because when we talk about pelagic and reef mantas, there is a size comparison for sure. And this week here's mango season. Now it's at the end of mango season, so we wanted to show you some really, really cool mangoes. This is actually pretty heavy. Check this out. We picked this mango this week from the neighbor's tree, I have to say. This is our tree. But think of reef mantas, they are smaller. I'll get to this in a second. And the pelagic manta rays are bigger. So I think this is a really, really cool way to show things. So Michelle just said to me, you have to use this as a comparison. And so I did. Thanks, Michelle. Anyway, so let's dive right into it. The best way to do that is if I flip the screen and I show you some stuff that we prepared for you. So let me just push the button. Here we go. And here's it's all simple, guys. Tara is here. Super. Thank you for being here, Tara. Every week, super fan. I love it. I hope I get more of these over the years, or over the weeks, or soon. So pelagic versus reef mantas. So we're going to look at size. I already gave it away a little bit. There's definitely a size difference. And then habitat and distribution, where they live. Aloha, Tara. And then coloration. And let's go to the first part, but I'm gonna look at these three different things here right now. Size. First of all, I wanted to show you how the measurement is. We're gonna go wingtip to wingtip, yeah? Actually, some people say fin tip to fin tip, but I like wingtip to wingtip because my last name is Wing, might as well bring it in. And so that's for the size when we look for. So a grown up, really a pelagic manta ray, they're up to 22 feet. That would be about 7 meters for our German people that maybe listen to me, or all the Europeans and metric thinking people. And reef mantas, well, we believe that Big Bertha is about the 14 feet, 12, 14 feet. I have a picture of her here in a second, but just to give you, that's about 5 meters. Alrighty, so we're gonna establish now a size. And I have a picture prepared for you where this was found years ago by Rich Osada. He's 15 years ago, I found it. And he found it somewhere on the East Coast. And he brought this back, and we just looked at it. It was unbelievable. And what you see here, obviously, that is a woman standing right here. I would think it's the 1920s. And that is a very, very sad story of a dead pelagic manta ray. So huge, I mean huge. And if you think of this is probably 30 feet wide, even bigger than that, yeah. Then every foot of a manta ray is about 100 pounds. That would make this a 2,500 to 3,000 pound creature. Crazy. Now the story behind this picture, the only thing that Richard told us is that it was on the East Coast, New Jersey. This picture was taken in New Jersey. So maybe in the 1920s, the pelagic were still in abundance up there, but this is definitely actually a gruesome picture. So pelagic manta ray, so comparisons for size. And here's our Big Bertha. I love to show this picture. This is our Big Bertha right on top of a scuba diver, and it's pretty obvious how big she is. But reef mantas are smaller, so up to 14 feet, and the pelagic manta rays up to 22 feet. All right, so moving on to the next. Habitat and distribution. So I don't really have here footage or imagery. I'm just gonna read this back to you guys. But pelagic manta rays, they live in a tropical, subtropical, and moderate waters. And the reef manta is actually only in tropical and subtropical waters. You would see that right here, distribution, and right here. Now, what does pelagic mean? So a pelagic means that the fish actually lives in the pelagic zone of the ocean. And that means being neither close to the bottom nor near the shore, although they may also swim inshore. So have I ever seen a pelagic manta ray in all these dives? Maybe a handful of times, super rare. And they just sometimes maybe swim inshore. And you would maybe be diving here maybe in 60 feet of water, and in front of you is the blue, and it just goes deeper and deeper, and then you would be just lucky that a pelagic manta ray might swim by. But you maybe see them also in the like 2 or 3 or 4 miles offshore if you're lucky. So a reef manta, the reef fish stays close to the reef. Well, near shore environments such as island groups, atolls, and continental coastlines. So yeah, that's versus pelagic, the reef manta, and like the name already says, reef manta stay close to the reef. And of course here in Hawaii we have the reef right in front of our door. But if you go, for example, Australia and the reef is offshore, you would be travel to the reef first, and then you would see reef mantas within the reef. And to clarify, what we see here regularly on the Kona coast, on the west coast of Hawaii, is the reef manta. So this is the one we see on a regular basis. Cool. Already we got that already covered. And what's the next one? Coloration. So then I'm going to go back to some imagery here in a second, but just to clarify, a pelagic has dark blay-grayish top sides, and actually the reef manta has it as well. But the pelagic manta ray has more dark on the underside, and also on the cephalic fins around its mouth. And here the term black ray comes in, where there has been manta rays spotted that are really, really black. And I have a video for you guys here in a second. And on the reef manta as well, if you've seen the manta rays before here on the coastline, you would know that they are, yes, dark and blay grayish topside. And then they have a white underside with the dark spots and pigmentation on the bottom. So let's go into examples. Pelagic manta rays. Here's a pelagic manta ray. See how here the coloration of the eye and around this is all so dark. See the inside of the cephalic fin, it's dark. It maybe looks similar to a reef manta, but actually this is also darker. So this would be a pelagic manta ray. Right off the bat, we would see that. We would say, yeah, that's pelagic. And now I show you a video that Justin Summers took this summer, actually. And I'm going to have to just push the button. Now check this out. This is a pelagic manta ray that found offshore. I don't know, maybe a mile, 2 miles offshore. And check out, this is definitely very black. And look at this super cool coloration. With the sun rays coming down, it just looks so cool. Yeah, and definitely really black. You wouldn't even understand when you look down, and you wouldn't see the black against the sun rays, that this is a manta ray. I just love this clip. I'm just going to play it again. Lots and lots of black on this pelagic manta ray. Very cool. Alrighty. So this would be a coloration for a pelagic manta ray. And now we're going to just jump over to the reef manta. And yeah, okay, reef manta. They have very similar, the darker side on top. But you know, then some people say they're black on top and white on the belly. That is actually, they have these beautiful shoulder patches here and up here too. And the same thing that just we saw in the other video, when the sun rays come down, you would actually see this manta ray to have this cool counter shading, black on top and white on their belly. If you would dive during the day and you would look against the sun, you wouldn't actually see that the manta ray is above you, because it blends in with the light from the sky. So yeah, so coloration for the reef mantas is darker side, like similar to the pelagic, but the underside is very white, and then they have the spot pattern all over. And of course, for the comparison, who's who and the naming, we look at this spot pattern here between their gill slits. All right, so that was a very simple comparison by distribution and where you find them, and size and coloration and so forth. And then I promised you guys that I would show you also how James Ray and Martina Ray met. And you maybe know my real story behind it, but I'm going to tell you anyway. But I'm going to play this video here, and there will be some music in the background. I hope this works out, that I can talk over it. But it's kind of a cute story. You find this video also in my library of manta rays. And James was offshore on October 1st, 2004. Jim was on the boat and just traveling with Ron Gittins on his boat. And then you see Manta Ray. So these mantas have never been seen before. And so he took pictures and then we named them afterwards. And we thought Manta Ray is the perfect name for this one manta ray. James Ray, St. James Ray is the other one. And the biggest reason for that was at that time, St. James Ray was really in hot pursuit of Manta Ray. And yeah, that is kind of a similar thing to the story I can tell you how we met, Jim and I. Although I have to always put in that Jim tells a different story how we met. So that's, of course, always an option here. But this is just a really cool video where you can see lots of pictures. It's made to a video, but you see the coloration of these pelagic manta rays, darker around the mouth. And yeah, you can see St. James Ray really right after Manta Ray and trying to chase her, I guess. I just let you enjoy these pictures for a little bit. Yeah, and Jim was in blue water. That means it was offshore. There's no bottom to it. And these guys were just cruising. You see here actually the tail from the manta ray, from Manta Ray, and James Ray is right behind her on her tail. So, just a good story to tell, right? And again, you can find the video of St. James and Manta Ray. I put it in the show notes, and then you can find in the description, and then you can find how we met and review it again. Anyway, so this is for imagery today. I'm gonna come back to us, to me over here. Yeah, Tara, thank you. Love it. It's a good story, isn't it? I mean, I do want to cover real quick how Jim and I met, my story, but and I keep it short, of course. Yes. Can drag it out, but you know, just want to finish up and I promise you the story. I came in 1998 to Hawaii, just a tourist, German tourist, just traveling by myself, and I went diving, and I didn't really know what I was doing. I was a brand new diver, 6-8 dives, you know. I went night diving first, then people said you have to do the night dive. It was out with Eco Adventures. Mike Farmer was still running the show, and Amanda Steenman. So anyway, so I do the night dive, didn't really know what a manta ray is, but did the dive, and there was this guy on the boat, a very interesting guy, but you know, I was so excited, I didn't really know what was going on, I just was supposed to do this dive, and someone just, then he filmed this individual, he filmed me, he was filming everybody on the boat, and that's how he made a living, and so yeah, I bought the video. At the end, I was so blown away about the manta rays. I saw Big Bertha, I think, on the very first time, although I cannot prove that. I just think it was Big Bertha. And so I did the dive. We came back on the boat. The guy showed the video. I did pretty much threw money at him because I just wanted this video so bad. It was still VHS tape. Can you believe this? It's such a long time ago. And bought the video. And the end of the story here is that I married the cameraman who sold me my first manta ray video. And life changes on a dime, right? Things change fast. How life throws you these things. And I'm married to Jim for, it's coming up to 17 years. And we still continue to work with the manta rays. And I really, really, truly enjoy these creatures and talking about them, showing them to people, filming them. Oh, everything I can do all day about the manta rays. Anyway, this was my story. I thank you for being here with me. If you watch the replay, look also in the description if you want to see more about the library that we have. And I will see you again next week at 11 o'clock on Wednesday. I haven't decided on the topic, but if you have something you want me to talk about, just put it in the comments. Give me a share, give me a like. I just love that stuff. And talk to you later. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.